Hello, this is Bern, and on today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you four destructive lies men hurt women with so you can stop falling for them once and for all. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can attract the man and the relationship you want without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy techniques. Now, there's many lies, if you haven't noticed, that men share with women and hurt women with. I'm gonna share four right now that are common, but not necessarily lies that when you're in the middle of it, you treat them as lies, therefore hurt you, hurt the relationship, lower your self-esteem, and I'm just sick and tired of hearing women getting hurt by blatant BS, so here goes the first one. No one will love you like I do. This is the cry for help that a very small and very wounded man will blurt out when he's afraid of losing you, to try to keep you down and try to prevent you from growing, expanding, and finding someone better than him. If a guy gets to the point where he's blurting out to you that no one in your life will love you like he does, that's a scary situation, number one. That's kind of creepy, actually. But beyond that, it's not true. You can't find love, irrespective of who you're with, if the guy that you're with is not respecting you or loving you the way you want to, but he still has the coglioni to share with you that he is the best man for the job, then just take it with a grain of salt. And if the need in that moment for you is to move on, don't let that stop you, please. Second one is so prevalent and sometimes so nuanced because it's not spelled out the way I'm sharing with you all the time. Sometimes it's more nuanced than this, but the gist of it is you're not blank enough. You're not beautiful enough. You're not sexy enough. You're not thin enough. You're not smart enough. You're not accomplished enough. You're not, whatever it is that you're not enough is bullshit. Don't buy into it. And the only judge of how much you are should be you. how much is enough, right? So what I'm sharing with you right now is not that you can't learn from people sharing with you things you can get better at, but when it comes to your intrinsic value as a woman, when it comes to your beauty, when it comes to your courage, when it comes to your vulnerability, he's not necessarily the best judge of that. And you should stay away, or at the very least, close a door in someone's face, metaphorically speaking, not physically speaking. When somebody's telling you you're not good enough, smart enough, beautiful enough, sexy enough, thin enough, it's not true, it's BS. Don't fall for it. Third one, and this happens sometimes earlier in relationships. So here's the situation, a guy connects with you and you like him, there's chemistry, he likes you. I mean, it's a mutual thing. And he does not want something serious. So rather than telling you, I want to do a hit and run, right? Or I want to have a friend with benefits in you, he's going to share sometimes, this is like, let's not mess things up. Let's not label things for now. Keyword here, for now. For now typically turns into forever. So while I'm not an advocate of becoming somebody's boyfriend, the first date you meet, that shouldn't be happening. The guy should have a clear idea as to where he's headed, what he wants, and what he's committing to, even if it's a small step. And if he's unwilling to do that, and he's the kind of guy who's selling you on the idea of connecting with him, and you shouldn't mess things up right now, you shouldn't put too much pressure on each other, you shouldn't label things for now, then without telling you where he's going, my recommendation is to run away. Because typically for now means forever. Last one is, and women fall for this many times, is, I was just busy. I'm too busy, right? The too busy excuse is one of the worst ones. Why? Because you'll find time for anything you find meaningful in your life. Anything that's a must in your life, you'll find time for. Now, am I sharing that a guy can't have an emergency or super late meeting and things happen? Yes. But the consistent, persistent excuse of I'm too busy for this, it's an excuse. If you want something, you make it happen. And if you don't want something or you don't have time, then you step out of it. You don't do the in-between of giving her just a little bit, enough for her not to move away, but not enough for her to have a fulfilling and amazing love life. So there you go, four big blatant lies women fall for and sometimes destroy self-esteem with. Don't fall for them. If you find this is helpful for you and you want to figure out a way to create attraction more quickly with less pain, then you're in luck. I created a free video training. All you have to do is go to the first link on the description of this video, click on it, enter name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to watch that free training right now. If you like this video, click like or thumbs up, send me a comment, let me know what you learned from it and what you want to do based on what you learned. And last but not least, if you find that you're in a place in your life where you're done with just watching videos and maybe reading blogs and you want hand-holding, help, accountability to attract your soulmate. And to do that now versus years from now through trial and error, then you want to find out if you and I are fit to work together. Second link under the description of this video will allow you to apply to connect and work together. Thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.